Hi, I'm Sumit Gulwani. I lead a research and engineering team that develops APIs for programming by examples. These APIs are used inside various Microsoft products, including Excel, PowerShell, and OMS. Today, I'm going to show you a demo of these APIs in the context of a data preparation and analysis task. Consider this text file that contains 911 call records. At the top, there is some metadata, and then there is a header row, and then each line contains a single 911 call record entry whose various fields are separated by the pipe character. Suppose I want to answer questions such as, when are vehicle accidents most common? As in which hour of the week? Is it Fridays at 5 p.m. or Wednesdays at 4 p.m.? To answer such questions, we will need to extract various fields from these records. In particular, we'll need to extract this date and map it to the corresponding weekday. In this case, this is Friday. We will need to extract the time and map it to the corresponding hour bucket. In this case, this is 1 p.m. And then we will need to filter the rows that correspond to vehicle accidents. So we gave this task to Python programmers in a user study, and they took 30 minutes on average to do this task. Now I can do this task in 30 seconds using our APIs. This 10 to 100 productivity increase is very useful for data scientists who end up spending 80% of their time wrangling data. Even more interestingly, I can do this task without writing a single line of code. This is very significant since 99% of computer users do not know programming. And this kind of investment can bring programming to the masses. The underlying technology is called program synthesis, or programming by examples. This is a new frontier in AI where the computer programs itself. The user simply provides input-output examples, or in some cases, simply points to the input data. And the tool comes up with an indented program for automating the task. These programs can be synthesized in different programming languages such as C#, Python, or R. Now you can watch the demo that I'm going to show you by wearing one of two hats. Either you are an end user who would like to leverage these technologies for your data preparation task, or you are a product developer who would like to leverage the underlying APIs to develop such distinguished features for your own product and bring the program synthesis innovation to your customers. Now, the first step in analyzing this file would be to ingest it into a tabular format. Tools like Excel, Power BI, and SSIS allow you to do this by specifying the various parameters, such as what is the row delimiter, what is the column delimiter, how many lines to skip from the top, whether or not there is a header row. Our data wrangling tool also allows you to do this by specifying various parameters. But when I point this tool to the file, then it automatically analyzes the patterns in this file and is able to automatically infer the various parameters, such as the column delimiter, which in this case is a custom separator, which is the pipe character, the fact that there are column headers, the file encoding UTF-16, and the fact that there are 10 lines to be skipped at the top. Now, more generally, whenever you have a rich UI inside any product, you can ask the question whether program synthesis APIs can be used to automatically predict the various parameters in that UI, either by analyzing the underlying data or from the past user actions. So in this case, our file ingestion API is able to infer the parameters in the UI by simply analyzing the patterns in the file. And when I hit finish, the inferred metadata is used to parse the file. Now let me get rid of the columns that I do not need. And let's look at this description column. It contains various subfields that I'm interested in, such as date and time. Splitting this long string into the various constituent fields is not easy because there are multiple delimiters such as the hyphen character, the at character, the semicolon character. And even more challenging is the fact that not all occurrences of hyphens are delimiters, such as the ones that occur inside the date. Now, in order to split such strings into constituent subfields, we have developed an API to split columns by example. Now, when I invoke this API, it also tries to behave predictively, meaning it first tries to split the column without any examples, and then I can provide the examples at the places where it got it wrong. So in this case, it extracted the first column correctly and the second column correctly, but in the third column, there are some errors in row 3 and row 21 and so on. So now manually browsing for such errors can also be quite tedious, especially when the data set is large and the errors do not occur in your viewport. So when I go to the advanced mode, the interactive version of this API actually points out all the 6 different formats that occur in the data set, and I can quickly inspect the output on these 6 formats to identify where the errors are. And in this case, I give an example to fix the time column. And when I hit the apply button, the tool tries to learn a program which is consistent with the example that I provided. And then when I hit OK, the tool executes this program on the rest of the data set to produce the intended splitting. Now the next step in this task is to do some transformations, such as map the date to the corresponding weekday. Now I can do this using the derive column by example capability that we have developed. And all that I need to do is to give an example of the transformation that I want to do. So when I type Friday for this corresponding date, note that the autocomplete feature of the tool already provides me with the completed example. And when I hit enter, the tool tries to learn a program which is consistent with the example that I provided. So I will hit OK to accept the changes. Now if you look on the right side, the tool has started building the entire script as a series of steps. If I hover over this last step that I did, the tool actually shows me what kind of transformation it inferred. So in particular, it says that the transformation is to extract the day of the week from the date time. So now we would like to map the time column to the corresponding bucket. And I can again do this by giving an example. So suppose I want to map it to the corresponding half an hour bucket. All that I have to do is to give an example. For those of you who are familiar with the flash fill feature in Microsoft Excel, this capability is much more advanced than that, since it can manipulate dates, numbers, times. Now instead of the half an hour bucket, suppose I want to map it to the corresponding 2-hour bucket. Again, I can do this by means of simply providing an example. Now just imagine how much effort would it be if you were to do this by writing a program yourself. But in this case, I simply wanted the corresponding hour. So 1 p.m. suffices for me here. And the system is able to learn the transformation with again one example. Now, initially I promised you that I will be able to do this demo in 30 seconds, but I have gone much more than that. So it turns out that all these transformations that I did, I didn't really need to do them. I was doing them just to show you the various capabilities. So if you recall, within 10 seconds, I was at this screen where I was able to automatically ingest the file into a tabular format. And then this description column contains the relevant subfields that I'm interested in. If all that I wanted to do was to map it to the corresponding week hour, I can do that simply by giving an example instead of having to split it into the various constituent subfields. And now the last step in the demo is to filter the rows in the data set to those that corresponds to vehicle accident. I can do that by invoking the filter column feature. And maybe I want to use a predicate which says ends with vehicle accident. The moment I type V, the autocomplete suggestions pop up, and it not only avoids me having to type multiple keystrokes, but you can also see that it tells me what percentage of the rows will match if I were to pick a certain suggestion. But most significantly, it shows me that I was about to do a wrong computation without probably even realizing it, because there are certain rows in the data set that end with vehicle accident without a hyphen. Now, if you were a Python programmer and you did not notice this thing, you could have computed the wrong result without realizing it. So instead, what I want to use is the predicate which says contains vehicle accident as opposed to ends with vehicle accident. And when I do that, the system then ends up filtering the rows to the ones that correspond to vehicle accident. And all that I have to do now is to simply count the number of different V covers here. And now we notice that most vehicle accidents happen on Thursdays at 5 p.m. and then the rush hour traffic of the Wednesday is the worst overall. So you see, in 30 seconds, you are able to draw some very good insights from this data, and now you know when to avoid driving. If you want to do this demo yourself, send me email. Also, the underlying APIs are hosted on GitHub with appropriate documentation and samples. If you would like to use these APIs inside your own product, please get in touch and we would love to engage with you. Thank you.